In the Alameda and Contra Costa Hills, the Altamont Pass is home to hundreds of bird species. They hunt and play in the midst of 3,000 wind turbines. Those turbines can be deadly, especially to golden eagles.
There's an eagle right there.
Eagle.
Right here, flying
low. Below the horizon, right in front of the
Biologists tower. Doug Bell, Sean Smallwood, and Joe DiDonato study golden eagles.
It's got white in its tail, which means it's a subadult or a younger bird. The characteristic of a golden eagle is that the birds have white at the base of the tail and white in the wings in their earlier years to about the third or fourth year.
The Altamont Pass Wind Resource Area is within and adjacent to one of the densest nesting populations of golden eagles in the world.
Golden eagles are protected under federal law. It's illegal to kill a single eagle without a permit. According to Alameda County estimates, 35 golden eagles were killed by the Altamont's turbines in 2013. Scientists call the Altamont a population sink.
Their population's going down the drain. The Altamont is killing more eagles than the local population can reproduce. So it's taking out more youngsters than they can produce and replace themselves with.
That appears to be what happened to this young eagle.
The primary injury on this bird is the left wing. There's an amputation at the carpal joint. The carpal bone is shattered.
At the California Department of Fish and Wildlife in Sacramento, Krista Rogers is performing a necropsy similar to a human autopsy.
We describe this as blunt force trauma, which is consistent with a wind turbine strike, given the location where the bird was found.
Researchers knew the bird well.
The transmitter is going to stay on here about 3 years.
She was one of 18 golden eagles, like this one, that Bell and DiDonato are following through radio transmitters.
Go.
Four of them have died after hitting turbines, but not before revealing some very useful information.
One of the more valuable things that we've learned from our transmitters that we've placed on eagles is that they use the Altamont a lot. So that really means that everything they do out there is going to have an effect on golden eagles.
Shortly after the Altamont's wind farms opened in the 1980s, scientists discovered that hundreds of birds of prey were being killed there each year.
The Altamont was sort of seen as a black eye for renewable energy, because anytime someone was proposing a new wind farm, it would raise the specter of the Altamont Pass.
In 2005, chapters of the Audubon Society and other environmental groups took legal action to get wind companies to protect birds here.
So the companies agreed to remove portions of their turbine fleets from 2006 to 2018, when they would turn off all of their old turbines. We wanted to move towards getting the old turbines out of the Altamont Pass, because in a process called repowering, up to 30 old turbines can be replaced with one single new turbine, which then results usually in significantly less bird mortality.
All of the turbines in this wind farm, about 300 in total, have been turned off in preparation for repowering. Soon, they'll be replaced by just 10 turbines.
It's time to pull the old machines down and put new ones up.
Rick Miller works for EDF Renewable Energy, the California-based company that owns the wind farm. He says the repowering process will cost $35 million and will be partly offset by federal production tax credits for wind energy. 10 turbines like this one will produce enough electricity to power 12,000 California homes for a year.
The turbines are becoming much larger rotor diameters and much taller towers. So we've really been able to reduce the number of turbines required to produce a tremendous amount of energy.
And that means there aren't as many for birds to hit. Companies can also place the turbines more strategically. Scientists believe fewer turbines and better placement are key to protecting wildlife.
300 meters.
Ecologist Sean Smallwood has been studying birds in the Altamont since the late 1990s. He advises companies on where to put their turbines to minimize bird deaths. This wind farm, called Buena Vista, or Beautiful View, was one of the first to be repowered. That was 7 years ago.
At Buena Vista, the repowering that happened there was very effective, I think. It probably reduced avian fatalities by about 80% or better.
This is where the old turbines were. And this is also where the burrowing owls nest. And so fatality rate was pretty high.
When we repowered, we put the new turbines up on the top of the hill where the burrowing owls are not.
So our burrowing owl fatality rate dropped to zero in 3 years of monitoring. That's why.
Smallwood says that when the Altamont was first built, wind energy companies installed over 7,000 turbines, more than twice as many as there are today. They gave little consideration to bird safety.
Those are the most dangerous turbines in the Altamont Pass on record.
There's one 120 kilowatt turbine down there, now removed, but it's on record as having killed one eagle per year for 10 years.
And the reason is because there's a lot of eagle traffic through the low spots of the Altamont Pass.
The birds fly lower in some areas to avoid wind resistance and to hunt for ground squirrels. Golden eagles have keen eyesight, which is good for hunting prey, but it doesn't help the birds detect wind turbines, especially when they're focused on other things.
Social interactions are very important. So an eagle responding to other eagles, chasing each other around or chasing some other birds. These are dangerous social interactions that lead up to what we call events, near misses.
The federal government has recently stepped up enforcement of laws aimed at protecting golden eagles. It's prosecuted two wind companies whose turbines killed golden eagles in Wyoming.
The prosecution of those two companies certainly sent a message to companies across the country. There is incentive there to come in and work with us.
That incentive is new permits, which allow wing companies to kill a small number of golden eagles each year.
We approach the permits as a positive step, which might seem a little counterintuitive. For example, why would Audubon be okay with giving people permission to kill birds? Before it was sort of chaos, there was no real regulation, there was no real enforcement, and we know birds were getting killed in large numbers. Now we can actually keep track of that, we can hold people accountable, and we can take steps to remedy the problem.
With repowering and a greater understanding of bird behavior, scientists and environmental groups hope there can be more clean energy with fewer bird deaths.